This approach will prevent your system from going down. This approach is very less talked about, but very, very important. I'm talking about negative caching. It's extremely simple approach, but in many of the cases, if you don't consider it, you can enter into the denial of service attack too. So let's quickly get started. So what is caching? Caching is a very simple thing that I'm talking in terms of backend systems, that a person makes a request to the backend service, and then there are multiple services on which that person needs to make request. For example, you can make a request for a booking that, hey, can you give me flights from Delhi to Bombay on a particular date? And then you can make calls to multiple suppliers, for example, Indigo or SpiceJet. In the real world, there are different suppliers, but for your mind mapping, you make calls to the multiple supplier, get the data, and then give it to the customer. And it will work fine. And also, you will cache the data so that the next time when the request comes, if you have the data in the cache, you will give the data from the cache, else you will make call to the dependent services. Now, this approach will work fine. There is no problem at all that you make a request, you get the data from the dependent services, and then you cache it and give the data back to the customer so that next time when the request comes, you can give the data from the cache. And there are multiple cache eviction policy as well, which I'm not going to talk about now. But this approach everyone knows about. You cache the data. But what if people are trying to query for a particular date of a flight on which the flight is not available? For example, can you give me a flight on, let's say, 31st of December on a particular year? And let's say the flight results are zero from all the dependent services. Or let's say the API fails. You make a call for a particular date. Let's say the API always fails for a particular dependent services. The scenarios can be even more complex, or you can imagine, let's say you get the zero result. So in those cases, the problem is that because of a bad request, a person making a request on a particular day which is not available, so you won't be caching the data. Now, since you won't be caching the data, the next person who calls your backend service will again make the same call. So in this way, you will keep on making the calls for the negative scenarios as well, which is not the good case. So what this negative caching says is that you cache not just the positive response, you cache not just the days in which the flight is available, but you also cache the days on which flight is not available so that you can rely on this. And it looks very simple when I talk about it, but many times we don't consider the negative cache. For example, if you try to get a value from, let's say, if you want to try to get a user email for a user name. Now, people can try to bring your system down by calling your API with random user IDs, which do not even exist. And in those cases, you will make call to the backend system and you might find a username email. And in those cases, you will cache it. But in case if you don't find a user email because somebody is just bombarding your system with random emails, in those cases, you will end up bringing these systems down. And many times these things can be very complex. For example, if you consider give me data for booking ID X. So in those cases, you might end up making calls to five different tables if that's how you have designed the system. And then, you know, these dependent services can go down for the random IDs. So if those IDs don't exist, then you will unnecessarily be making call to the multiple systems. So that's a very important and very simple concept to use the concept of negative caching. It requires special handling because now you have to handle one extra case of when the key is not present in your overall system. So it can become a wrong approach if your system is very simple and still you are trying to introduce it. But in a highly scalable system, it's important to cache the negative responses as well. So just keep in mind, I have not considered the other aspects of caching and other approaches. There are multiple online videos. I'm sure you would have already checked it, or if not, then you can check them out. But this particular topic has not been given as much importance in those videos. So I thought, why not share about it? So yeah, that's it. I hope you liked the video. And till the next time, bye.